and welcome to WARN World News, reporting to you from St. Michael's Tower.
Pope Benedict XVI recently declared a year for priests and invited the world to celebrate the great dignity of the priesthood. He pointed to St. John Vianney as a man who exemplified this great dignity.
St. John Vianney was born in France and grew up during the bloody persecution of the French Revolution. Even though many priests were exiled or died at the guillotine, he listened to the call of God to become a priest. He was ordained in 1815.
The young man was assigned to a parish in the village of Ars, and it was there he would spend the rest of his life. Due to the suppression of the church, the faith of the village had suffered greatly, so he immediately began visiting his absent parishioners, especially the sick and the poor.
His time was spent in prayer and penance, and he often went days without eating. When he did eat, it was often only a boiled potato or a piece of hard bread. His hunger was offered up for the souls of sinners.
He spoke with such conviction and love for God. He touched those who heard him, converting thousands. He also had the gift of reading souls and would remind sinners of forgotten sins.
The cure was a resolute enemy of immodest public dancing. He went so far as to deny absolution to those who would not stop attending such dances. When people would then go to other churches to receive absolution, he commented, "If other priests want to send them to hell, it is up to them."
As the reputation of this holy man spread throughout Europe, the faithful sometimes waited days for him to hear their confession. By 1855, there were 20,000 pilgrims a year making the pilgrimage to the remote village. And the cure of Ars became one of the greatest confessors the world has ever known.
But not everyone was pleased with him. For 35 years, Satan physically assaulted and tormented the saint. At night, the devil would make frightful noises for hours on end. The holiness of St. John Vianney was so powerful, the devil told him, "If there were three such priests as you, my kingdom in France would be ruined."
St. John Vianney was accused of being a dull, insignificant man who had a poor memory and a weak voice, who was frail and unattractive and did nothing the secular world would consider admirable. Yet this humble saint was chosen by God to be the example and high standard for priests all over the world.
Signing off for WARN World News, I'm Dan.
And I'm Mary. You have been warned.